Please adhere to YouTube's selected guidelines before viewing the content of this video. I do not encourage or condone any products, actions, or behaviors shown in this video. All videos are produced in a safe, professional, and controlled environment. Please do not attempt to replicate any actions performed during video. All actions are performed by professionals.
Alrighty, so today I'm going to be smoking and reviewing the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco, which I will admit I am quite excited to do, as I have heard some amazing things about this rolling tobacco right here. I have heard that it might very well be one of the best, if not the absolute best, roll your own tobacco for sale in the United States. And so as such, of course, I certainly am quite excited to try it. I certainly am quite excited to see how good it actually is. And of course, I certainly am quite excited to let you guys know what I think of it as well. And I certainly do expect it to be better than not, because I have previously tried some Peter Stokkebye pipe tobaccos before, and those were pretty dang good, if I do say so myself. And since there is a pipe tobacco version of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag called the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam number 83, I certainly am thinking that this stuff is probably going to be a lot better than not. Y'all heard me correctly though, there is a pipe tobacco version of this tobacco right here. It is, instead of being a shag cut rolling tobacco, a ribbon cut pipe tobacco, but the blend of it is apparently the exact same. So I do suppose it's not too far of a stretch to say that this is literally a pipe tobacco that you're meant to roll cigarettes with. As I'm sure is obvious, I am expecting a much better smoke than not. But what is Peter Stokkebye as a brand? Well, the Stokkebye family has been in the tobacco business in various ways since the 1880s. However, Peter Stokkebye as a brand has not existed for nearly that long. It was first brought onto the market in Denmark in the early 1970s by a third generation Stokkebye by the name of Peter Stokkebye. And soon after its introduction into the market in Denmark, they started to sell Peter Stokkebye branded tobaccos in the United States as well. And today, I would argue that Peter Stokkebye roll your own tobaccos and pipe tobaccos are more popular than ever before. Peter Stokkebye today is a pretty well-known nameplate. They're really well-known for their bulk pipe tobaccos. They're really well-known for their rolling tobaccos, and they are more so than not pretty highly regarded and considered to more so than not be a pretty high quality pipe tobacco and rolling tobacco brand. Today, Peter Stokkebye as a brand is owned by the Scandinavian tobacco group Lane LTD, which is a massive tobacco conglomerate that has a focus on cigars, pipe tobaccos, and roll your own tobaccos. And even though Peter Stokkebye is owned by a massive tobacco conglomerate these days, it is still, from what I've heard at least, much higher quality stuff than not, both from a roll your own tobacco perspective and from a pipe tobacco perspective. But what is the Amsterdam Shag roll your own tobacco in specific? Well, I'll be frank, I don't know exactly when the Amsterdam Shag roll your own tobacco was first introduced either in Denmark or in the United States. However, I do figure that it was probably introduced pretty close to the inception of Peter Stokkebye as a brand, but I don't know that for sure, so I can't say anything with certainty. However, what I do know is that the Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco is a shag cut Virginia Burley blend of tobacco, with the Burley being specifically a flue-cured Kentucky Burley. And apparently this stuff is medium strength rolling tobacco, as we can see from the halfswear text right here. Halfswear in Danish means half strength. It's generally a mix of like light and strong tobacco, so I take that as a whole, meaning a medium strength tobacco. So yeah, this is a medium strength shag cut Virginia Burley blend of rolling tobacco. And apparently the flue cured Burley Kentucky, the flue-cured Kentucky Burley tobacco, to say it correctly, gives the entire roll-your-own tobacco a pretty unique taste. And I certainly am expecting to get a pretty unique taste, and I certainly am looking forward to seeing what that taste is actually like. But what am I expecting taste-wise from the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, and what are my expectations as a whole for this roll your own tobacco right here? Well, taste-wise, I am expecting a mildly sweet, mildly citrusy sort of Virginia tobacco taste as the main overtone. Then as an undertone, I am expecting a slightly nutty tobacco taste with a little bit of spice in there as well. That's what I've heard this stuff tastes like at least. And so as such, that is what I'm expecting it to taste like. That sounds like a pretty interesting taste to me. A mix of sort of sweet and citrusy and nutty with a little bit of spice. That sounds really interesting. And I'm really looking forward to seeing just how interesting it actually is kind of thing. I certainly am looking forward to it, because that sounds honestly right up my alley. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I am expecting strength-wise for this stuff right here to be very much a medium strength tobacco. I'm not expecting it to be super overpowering by any means, nor am I expecting it to be super light, but I am expecting it to be more of a heavy medium tobacco. That is for sure not super heavy by any means, definitely not like a full strength roll your own tobacco, but definitely heavier than not, and definitely a heavier medium tobacco than not. I'm expecting roughness and smoothness wise, it probably is going to be a little bit rough kind of thing, but probably smoother than not if I had to guess. And I am expecting the spice to give the tobacco a little bit of a kick kind of thing in the back of your throat. So I'm definitely expecting it to be a little bit rougher than not, but kind of in an odd way if I had to guess. And I'm expecting the roughness and smoothness of the Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco as a whole to be right around a 7 out of 10 on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being the smoothest and 10 being the roughest. I'd have to say, quality-wise, I'm expecting a fantastic quality Roll Your Own Tobacco from this stuff right here, as it's a Peter Stokkebye branded. And I am expecting the ease of rolling to be, well, very easy. I'm expecting this stuff to be really, really, really easy to roll because it's a shag cut Roll Your Own Tobacco. Those are my expectations for the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, though. And so now, before I go any further into the video, I want to go ahead and introduce you guys to everything I'm going to be using to roll the cigarette with in today's video. Besides, well, the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, I do suppose, as I've already introduced that. Today, I'm going to be using my raw rolling machine to roll the cigarette that I'm going to be smoking in today's video. I will admit, I'm not very good at rolling cigarettes, and so as such, I'm using this as a little bit of a crutch to make sure that I can actually provide a high-quality cigarette review in today's video, and to make sure that I don't roll it really badly and I end up having a bad smoking experience because of how badly I rolled it. I'm using this to ensure that I get a good smoke, let me just put it that way kind of thing. The papers I'm going to be using in today's video are some Elements ultra-thin rice papers, which I'm using due to the lack of paper taste that they provide. And today I'm going to be smoking essentially an unfiltered cigarette, but at the same time, not really, because today the filter I'm going to be using is a raw black cardboard filter tip. And today I'm going to be rolling all of the Amsterdam Shag. I'm going to be rolling all of the Amsterdam Shag. Today I'm going to be rolling the Amsterdam Shag on an Odagiri rolling tray made in Japan that I bought at a thrift shop for like 99 cents a couple years ago. Now, this is a great rolling tray. I really, really, really do like it. But with all that out of the way, now that I have introduced you guys to the materials I'm going to be using to roll the cigarette, I do suppose I should probably go ahead and hop into the packaging of, well, the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco. After I go over the packaging, I'm going to go ahead and get the pack of Roll Your Own Tobacco all opened up. I'm going to go and take a look at the inside of the Roll Your Own Tobacco packaging. Then after that, I'm going to go ahead and get this stuff cracked open. I'm going to go and take a look at the what the blend of the tobacco actually looks like, what it feels like, what the moisture level of it is like, what the quality of it is like, what it smells like, all that sort of fun stuff, you know what I'm saying? Then after that, I'm going to go ahead and get this stuff right here rolled up into a cigarette. And then after that, I'm going to go ahead and get to smoking and let you guys know how the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag actually tastes, how it is in general kind of thing, what the roughness, the smoothness of it is like, and everything like that kind of thing. I'm just going to let you guys know what the smoking experience of this stuff actually is. Then after that, I'm going to go ahead and give you guys my final thoughts on this rolling tobacco right here. And then after that, I'm going to go ahead and give it a rating. But first off, as said, we got to go ahead and cover the packaging, which I will admit I am a bigger fan of than not. It doesn't quite come off as like a super luxury look, but it's definitely like almost there, I'd have to say. I really, really, really like the basic black background with the white and I'd have to say like sort of like grayish silver sort of details on the forefront and everything like that kind of thing. I really, really, really like it. And they contrast really well and give it a very nice sort of luxury-esque look. I'd have to say this is more of a classy look than a luxury look, if you ask me kind of thing. A luxury look, I'm thinking it's got to be a little bit more simple kind of thing. But like for a classy look, I think they've nailed it. I ain't gonna lie. I think they've nailed it. Now, I do want to acknowledge this is a newer pack design for the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag. It used to be on a sort of burgundy background and whatnot with the same overall more so than not design as the forefront. The black background, though, is a new design. I don't know exactly when they changed the design of this stuff right here, but they did do that sometime recently. But yeah, more so than not, I am a fan of this packaging, that is for sure. From a distance, the black with the massive sort of like a logo right here, the massive sort of Peter Stokkebye logo right there, is definitely more distinct than not from a distance, that is for sure, but not like the most distinct. You really do have to kind of know what you're looking for, that is for sure. And when this had a burgundy background, I definitely do think it was more distinct from a distance than not. I remember seeing it a couple years ago in a shop, and I was like, oh, that's really distinct from a distance kind of thing. This is not as distinct from a distance, in my personal opinion, but if you know what you're looking for, it's definitely more distinct than not, that is for sure. And overall, more so than not, it is a pretty nice, classy, yet not quite luxury look that I am a fan of. It very much comes off as slightly above gas station classy, in my personal opinion, but not quite like pipe tobacco classy, if you ask me, because Peter Stokkebye is not like a super high-end pipe tobacco brand or roll your own. Well, I guess they are like one of the highest end roll your own tobacco brands in the United States, but for their pipe tobaccos, they mainly sell like bulk blend pipe tobaccos and stuff like that kind of thing. And so as such, they're not like the most high-end stuff. They're still classy because it's a pipe tobacco and everything like that kind of thing, but they're not like the most high-end luxury pipe tobaccos in the world. And so it makes sense for this not to be the most super luxury look in the world, just more of a classy look that is still very much more classy than a gas station piece of packaging. But you know, those are my overall thoughts on the packaging. I haven't even covered the details of the packaging yet, which I still need to do. More so than not, though, I do like this packaging, that is for sure. I'm a big fan. I am a sucker. I'm a complete sucker for tobacco packaging with black and white on it with like a little bit of silver or gold or something like that kind of thing. I am a sucker for packaging like this, I will admit. And I really like the more simplistic look to it than not. Starting at the top right here, though, we can see there is a sort of, that is a sort of like, it's sort of a silvery gray band, I'd have to say. A silvery gray band that goes all the way across the pouch of rolling tobacco. So technically speaking, the design does stretch all the way around, which is pretty nice if I do say so myself. Below this line right here, we can see we go to the black background, which covers up the rest of the packaging right here and everything like that kind of thing. And on that black background, we can see it just says number 93 right there. The number 93 is all in that sort of silvery gray, not really super metallic, but at the same time, maybe slightly metallic. Nah, it's not really metallic in all honesty. I was kind of thinking it was for a minute, but it's not. It's sort of like a silvery gray, I definitely have to say. It just says number 93 right there. And then under that in white, it just says Amsterdam Shag right there. The reason it says number 93 is because there is another Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam tobacco. It's not a rolling tobacco, but the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam number 83 is this tobacco right here, but as a ribbon cut pipe tobacco. The 93 is in reference to the shag cut rolling tobacco, and the 83 is in reference to the pipe tobacco, which is pretty interesting if I do say so myself, which is why it says the number 93 right there. Under the number 93 text right here, as said though, it just says Amsterdam Shag, all in white, no sort of drop shadow, nothing like that kind of thing, all in a very, very, very bold, nice text, I definitely have to say, that looks a little bit more fancy and stylized than not, but not super stylized by any means, I definitely have to say. Under the Amsterdam Shag text right here in white, in a little bit of smaller text, we can just see it just says half swear cigarette tobacco. Half swear, as said a little bit earlier on in the video, just means half strength or medium strength in Danish. And then, of course, cigarette tobacco means cigarette tobacco. Under all of this stuff right here, we get the Peter Stokkebye sort of coat of arms right here, I definitely have to say. It just says quality at the top right here on this little ribbon, and then tobacco at the bottom right here on this little ribbon right here. We can see there's like a letter, some like leaves over here, some tobacco leaves over here kind of thing, some other ribbons down here. There's like a shield in the center with a P and an S right there, a barrel, two pipes looking like two clay pipes right there kind of thing. And then we can see there's like a crown, and then there's some like keys or something like that in the center as well. I don't know if those are actually keys. They look more like, to me, like those venomous plants that like the bugs fall in and then they can never get out because like the sap is like that sticky or something like that. Not a Venus flytrap, the other venomous plant. Those are really cool, I ain't gonna lie. Those are really cool. It looks more like that to me, in all honesty. We can see there is and this all connects up, the line goes around the shield and everything like that kind of thing. So the shield border connects up to the two letters right here. And then we can see there's like more leaves and stuff over here kind of thing, another leaf, and then there's a guy smoking pipe with an oar, I wanna say. And that's pretty much all there is to the design right here. Definitely a more intricate coat of arms design than not. It is a little bit too big for my personal taste, I will admit. But I see why they had to make it so big, because it is pretty intricate and it is a pretty nice look, I'm gonna lie. And this is all in that sort of silvery gray sort of look kind of thing that almost has a sort of like gold-ish sheen to it. I guess it does kind of have it's like silvery gray gold. It's kind of hard to describe in all honesty, but it's a good look nonetheless. To either side, we can see there is some white text. We can just see it just says made in Denmark right there, and then it just says premium tobaccos right there, just being a little bit of a selling point and everything like that kind of thing. Look, we're premium tobaccos made in Denmark, not made in the United States. Hey, we're a premium tobacco, you know what I'm saying? Makes sense. I'd do the exact same thing if I was making some packaging. Then under all of this stuff right here, we can just see in white it just says Peter Stokkebye right there in very, very, very cursive text, and that is very much the Peter Stokkebye logo itself. Looks pretty nice, and it isn't cursive enough where it's kind of hard to read what it is. It is very obviously Peter Stokkebye. No sort of drop shadow, shading, anything like that kind of thing. Just says Peter Stokkebye in a pretty basic white on that black background, I definitely have to say. And then under this right here, it just says since 1882. Not technically, I know it says since 1882. That's when the Stokkebye family first got into the tobacco business. I believe the grandfather of the guy who started Peter Stokkebye, was Eric-something Stokkebye. I can't remember what his second name was, but it was Eric Stokkebye. And he started a tobacco shop in Denmark, and he rolled tobacco and made pipe tobaccos and snuff and cigars in the back of the shop and everything like that kind of thing. So technically speaking, the family has been in the business since 1882, but the Peter Stokkebye brand has not been in business for nearly that long kind of thing. So it's not technically right, but it's not really technically wrong either. I guess it's more wrong than right kind of thing, but you gotta have a selling point being like, hey, look, we've been around for this long kind of thing. They haven't actually been around for that long kind of thing, but the brand has been in the business for that long kind of thing, which is they kind of been around for that long, but not really kind of thing. Yeah. Below this text right here though, which is in, once again, that weird silver, gold, gray sort of text kind of thing, we can see there is a sort of ribbon right here in that weird sort of silver, gold, gray with a white text on the in the center of it, with a white text in the middle of it. And it just says 50 free rolling papers included. So they do include rolling papers with this rolling tobacco right here, which is something I do appreciate. I'm not going to be using it though. I'm not going to be using those rolling papers though, because I have my Elements rolling papers, and those are my standard for rolling tobacco reviews. But I might have to give one a go in the future and see how it is kind of thing. I don't know. I'm thinking my Elements rolling papers are probably still better though, if I had to guess. But it is nice they include some free rolling papers. I wonder if they include filters as well. It does not say filters, just says rolling papers. I wonder. And then under this little ribbon right here, it just says net weight 1.23 ounces, which is a pretty odd ounce size, but not an odd gram size, because this contains 33 grams of tobacco. Then below the entire design right here, it just has a warning label right here. It just says warning, this tobacco product, or this product, not tobacco at all. It says, just says, warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical. And then below that, there is another little bit of a gold, silver, gray band, kind of hard to describe as said. And that's pretty much all there is to the design on the front of the packaging. More so than not, I like it. I like the design on the front of the packaging, that is for sure. and gives you all the information you need to know kind of thing, more than not to an extent, and sells the tobacco pretty well as well. Looks pretty decent from a distance, but isn't the most distinct. Looks pretty good up close as well. Definitely for a rolling tobacco, definitely a not a gimmicky look, more of a classy, almost luxury-esque look kind of thing. I like how this looks, to say the least kind of thing. But without further ado, let's go and move on to the back of the packaging right here. We can see at the top right here, another warning label just says, warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical. Then below that, we just get a bunch of information. The back of this is very informational. It's not really so much design oriented like the front. We can just see the barcode right here. A couple cigarette numbers right here with a little bit of like a barcode or something like that. Those cigarette numbers are all in white. It just says LEWL2KKMNN5LS2305251 8. I don't know what any of that means, but if you guys know, let me know in the comments down below. Then to the side of all of this right here, it just says in white, for special offers and more, visit www.peterstokkebyeusa.com, which is like their website and everything like that kind of thing, where you can get information about their pipe tobaccos and stuff like that kind of thing. I don't know if they actually have anything worthwhile on their site, I will admit. Just simply because I did not bother to sign up for it, but I probably should do that, I will admit. Below this right here, we can just see we get a Prop 65 warning. Just says, a warning, this product can expose you to chemicals, including tobacco smoke, which is known by the state of California to cause cancer, and nicotine, which is known by the state of California to cause birth defects and or other reproductive harm. For more information, go to www.p65warnings.ca.gov. Once again, California ruining the fun for everybody. I don't care about your Prop 65 warning. Let me smoke my damn cigarettes without a warning on them kind of thing. That's what I'm saying, at least. California, ruining the fun for everybody. Once again, no surprise, you know what I'm saying? No surprise. No offense if you're from California. But offense meant, I'm just kidding. But you know, California, the government, ruining the fun for everybody once again. I cannot believe this. No surprise, you know what I'm saying? It's California. Under all of this right here, though, it just says made in Denmark, as it said on the front of the packaging. Then under that, it just says imported by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group Lane LTD, Richmond, Virginia, 23223 USA. Sale only allowed in the United States. So I would assume, I don't know this for sure, but I would assume that Amsterdam Shag and other Peter Stokkebye Roll Your Own Tobaccos are also sold in Europe and stuff like that kind of thing. I couldn't find any information about that online, but I figure they probably are, especially if it specifies that sale only is only allowed in the United States. But yeah, made in Denmark. Doesn't actually say who it's made by. I mean, like, it says imported by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group Lane LTD. And from what I know, they've been the owner of Peter Stokkebye for quite a while, but it actually doesn't say made by them, because I do believe that Peter Stokkebye is a subsidiary of them, and Peter Stokkebye is still more so than not independently run from the Scandinavian Tobacco Group. Like, they're the owner of it, but they give Peter Stokkebye as a brand control over what they do and stuff like that kind of thing. From what I've heard, at least, I don't know, in all honesty, don't quote me on that. But imported by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group Lane LTD, that is for sure. But I don't know if it's actually technically speaking made by them, but it's technically speaking made by one of their subsidiaries, I do know. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is to... Oh, nope. Actually, there's a little bit more to the side of the packaging right here. There's nothing to the side of the packaging on this side. There's a little bit to the side of the packaging right here, which I almost forgot to talk about. We can see there's some numbers up here. Those numbers just read 61897. Don't know what that means. And then we can just see there's some other numbers right here, which just read 23180537256182. Don't know what that means. I assume that's probably the production code. Then we just get the Peter Stokkebye coat of arms right there in that sort of weird gold, silver, gray mess kind of thing. That's just the Peter Stokkebye coat of arms right there. And then it just says Peter Stokkebye in very, very, very small text right there. And then we can just see it just says 100% foreign grown tobacco right there. And then the top and the bottom, there's really not much going on. Just very much that sort of gold, gray, silver look once again. I'd have to say it's more gold than anything now that I'm thinking about it, but it's not really like actual gold. It's more like gold and silver and gray. I don't know. It's kind of weird in all honesty. But that's pretty much all there is to the packaging that you can actually see with the plastic wrap still on. And so now, without further ado, let's go ahead and get this all opened up, and let's go ahead and see what the rest of the packaging actually looks like. The feeling of the packaging right off the bat is very much, you can tell this is in a plastic wrap. It's paper in a plastic wrap from what I can tell, at least. And whoa, that stuff, I can smell it right off the bat. It's not like super distinct. But it smells pretty dang good. Let me just put it that way. It smells pretty dang good. Just put that in my backpack. Can't be littering or nothing like that kind of thing. And the quality of packaging overall is very much a, it's very much a plasticky sort of wrap. I definitely have to say, if I had to guess, this is a paper pouch wrapped in plastic. And so as such, you get a very plasticky texture on the pouch of rolling tobacco and everything like that kind of thing. Not a bad texture by any means kind of thing, but still very much a plasticky texture nonetheless. A little bit sticky kind of thing. Very much like a thick Ziploc bag, I'd have to say. Very much like a thick Ziploc bag. Let's go ahead and get this all opened up though, if I can. There's a piece of tape right here I have to pull up. So let's just go ahead and pull that up real quick if I possibly can. I'm trying not to break the plastic. Just wanna, do I need to cut this? This is not wanting to go. Like, I know it's taped closed, but I might just cut this, y'all. I might just cut this. I can always tape it back later. Got my Kershaw with me today. I love this knife. It's so good. Mugging y'all. I love this knife. I'm gonna go and cut this though, because this is, oh no, I just I was trying not to break the plastic, but looks like I already had. Oh well. Let's go ahead and just rip that the rest of the way. Whoopsies. Oh man, I didn't mean to break that plastic seal, but I did. Oh, it is what it is kind of thing. I broke that plastic seal. Whoopsies, it is what it is kind of thing. Well, nothing I can do about it now. That tape was really, really, really taped down. I ain't gonna lie, really, really, really taped down. Go and put my knife away. We can see the inside of the packaging though. Looks like it has a bunch of like market segmentation spiels and everything like that. I think we can see nothing going on up here. And we can see once again that sort of like black background. But we can see first off, wow, this stuff smells fantastic. Oof, oof, wow, that smells a little bit spicy, that is for sure. That smells a little bit spicy. Whoa, that smells really good. That smells really good, I ain't gonna lie. Well, we can see though, the Peter Stokkebye rolling papers right here on a burgundy sort of look, I definitely have to say. Just gonna go and peel those off. I'm not gonna be using this. So I'm just gonna put this down on the table I'm sitting at right now. And then we can see there's a bunch of information below where the rolling tobacco right here was. The rolling tobacco, or the rolling papers. I don't want to bother to get one out right now. The quality of them doesn't seem to be bad per se, but they don't seem to be bad. They seem to be thinner than that kind of thing. They seem to be okay rolling papers, but I'm not going to use one today. But we can see there's a bunch of information about not only this roll your own tobacco, but also their other roll your own tobacco varieties as well on the inside of the packaging right here. We can just see at the very top though, in white, it just says, when sealed, this sealed pouch, get my words all jumbled up. It just says, this sealed pouch guarantees factory freshness. When opening, please break the seal gently. I'll have to make sure I do that. Then under that text right there, there's a little bit of that, the whole sort of like silver, gold, weird look kind of thing. And then it goes and starts describing what the Amsterdam Shag is and what the blend of it is like and everything like that. It just says that the Amsterdam Shag is an original spicy blend of dark-fired Kentucky. Oh, it's actually dark-fired Kentucky. I didn't realize that. I just thought it was a flue-cured Kentucky. But no, it's actually dark-fired Kentucky. Dark-fired, I assume, still flue-cured to Kentucky though. Very interesting. So it says, it's an original spicy blend of excellent dark-fired Kentucky and full-bodied rich Virginia tobaccos. A generous flavor, a classic Dutch taste. It's a pretty good market segmentation spiel right there, a pretty good just market spiel, marketing spiel in general, because, well, they're setting me up to enjoy this, that is for sure. That sounds pretty scrumptious to me, and so I certainly am looking forward to seeing how this actually is, that is for sure. Then under that, there's another one of those lines right there. Then under that, it just has their other premium blend varieties. It just says, try these other premium blends from Peter Stokkebye. And then they go on to talk about the Turkish export, which uses a lot of Virginia and Oriental tobaccos. And they've got the Danish export, which is a delicate quality blend of top Virginia tobaccos from three continents. Wow. With a mellow, round Virginia taste. Interesting, interesting. Then they've got the London export, which is a traditional style, English style with a true Virginia blend. I assume that one would probably be more like a Golden Virginia or something like that kind of thing. Then there's Norwegian Shag, which is a quality blend consisting of smooth Virginia tobaccos and some air-cured burley and fine Oriental. A smooth American blend taste. And then there's a Stockholm blend, which is a full-bodied smoke featuring excellent Virginia tobaccos blended with a touch of dark-fired Kentucky for a full, silky, smooth, satisfying flavor. So I'd figure these probably go in order of strength. This one's probably the least strong, with this one's probably being the strongest. And then Amsterdam Shag is probably somewhere in there. I'm not exactly sure, in all honesty. But wow, they're doing a pretty good job of setting me up to want to try these other ones too. They just gave me all of the information about all of their other varieties. That's exactly what I'd do if I had a rolling tobacco brand. I'd be like, yeah, here's my all my other varieties. Go try all my other varieties if you like this one, kind of thing. That's what I'd do, and that's exactly what they did. I love to see it, you know what I'm saying? Absolutely love to see it. We can just see, once again, the Peter Stokkebye sort of coat of arms right there, and then we can just see the Peter Stokkebye logo once again right there. Without further ado, though, I do suppose I should probably go ahead and get this all opened up. So let's go ahead and break that seal gently, as it requested us to do, and take a look at what this stuff actually looks like, what it feels like, what the quality of it is like. Let's just smell this stuff real quick, though. Oh man, this stuff smells great. Oh man, this stuff smells good. It has a very nice grassy, slightly sort of nutty, almost pecan-y sort of a smell, with a decent amount of spice in there as well. Ooh, that smells good. That smells fantastic, y'all. Man, I want a candle that smells like this. That smells really good. That smells really, really, really good. Wow, I really like the smell of that. That smells fantastic. That smells absolutely fantastic, I ain't gonna lie. Wow. Well, certainly no complaints on my behalf. Whew, yeah, and that spice, when you really get your nose up close to it, it certainly hits the inside of your nose, that is for sure. That stuff smells amazing. This stuff right here smells amazing. You know, as I said, very much a grassy, sort of slightly nutty, spicy taste, I'd have to say. Well, with a little bit of sweetness coming from that sort of grassy smell. Or not taste, smell. With a little bit of sweetness coming from that grassy smell. Certainly no complaints on my behalf. What's the moisture content of this tobacco like? I'd have to say it's much drier than not. Just go lower on. It gets a little bit damper as you get towards the bottom of the package of rolling tobacco, and as you kind of mash it up a little bit with your fingers. But at the top, it's a little bit dry. But I think the moisture level is just about perfect kind of thing. It's not too moist, not too dry kind of thing by any means kind of thing. It's not turning dust in my fingers by any means, that is for sure. And it does indeed smell fantastic, and it looks pretty fantastic as well. That is what the tobacco itself looks like. Let's go and just get a little bit out, just like that kind of thing. And we can see, I'm just gonna go ahead and just kind of clamp it in my finger just a little bit like that kind of thing. We can see there are a bunch of light aspects. There are a bunch of pretty dark aspects too, but nothing really too dark nor too light. This is very much a, I'd have to say, medium blended tobacco. Very much a medium blended tobacco. Looks pretty scrumptious, if I do say so myself. And as we can see, the shag cut is a pretty fine shag cut. It's not the finest cut tobacco I've ever seen. A Japanese Kazami tobacco is definitely more finely cut, but this is still pretty finely cut tobacco nonetheless, and it does look pretty scrumptious, if I do say so myself. And yeah, look-wise, seems to be fantastic. Quality-wise, seems to be pretty good as well kind of thing. Smell-wise, it smells amazing. Moisture-wise, the moisture, it's a little bit on the dry side at the top and a little bit on the damp side at the bottom kind of thing, but I think the moisture level as a whole is just fine for rolling a cigarette with, so I don't think it's too damp, I don't think it's too dry or anything like that kind of thing. The seal definitely did a better job than not, that is for sure. So well, certainly no complaints on my behalf. This stuff looks scrumptious as a whole. Let me go and take a sip of water real quick. Was there anything else I wanted to cover real quick? Can't think of anything else I wanted to cover. Talked about the smell, and it still smells very much like I described. The quality as a whole looks fantastic. The cut is a pretty thin cut of tobacco, as we can see, but not the thinnest cut I've ever seen, but definitely one of the thinner cuts I've seen from tobacco you are meant to roll with. Although there are some thicker pieces that have made their way in there, I do want to acknowledge as well, but those are not a big deal one bit. Quality-wise, moisture-wise, a little bit dry, a little bit damp, depending on which area of the package you're reaching into kind of thing, but I don't think it's a big deal either way. And, yeah, doesn't really feel like it's got, like, humectants or, like, preservatives on it or something like that kind of thing. It doesn't feel goopy in the hand, which is really nice, I will admit. And, yeah, it's shaping up to be some good stuff. Quality-wise, smell-wise, look-wise, very much a medium blend, color-wise of tobacco. I'm looking forward to seeing how good this stuff actually is, and I certainly am expecting it to be a lot better than not, that is for sure. I do suppose, without further ado, though, I should probably go ahead and get to rolling my cigarette with, well, my Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, Roll Your Own Tobacco, now Shundai. So I'm going to go ahead and get my, something on my table. I had to move it. I think there was a bug on the table. I just flicked it just like that kind of thing. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get to rolling, though. First off, what I'm going to go ahead and do is I am going to go ahead and kind of just make a little bit of a filter with this. I think I've covered everything I wanted to cover about the actual look, smell, feel, quality, moisture, everything like that kind of thing of the Amsterdam Shag. Overall, seems to me like it's going to be a lot better than not, that is for sure. Seems to me like it's going to be a lot better than not. I hope that the taste it delivers is just as good as the smell it delivers, because the smell is pretty dang good. I'm not sure if it's going to be exactly to my preference based on the smell, but I'm thinking I'm still going to like it a lot more than not. Let me just put it that way kind of thing. And if that grassy sort of undertone is a little bit more pronounced than not, I definitely like the tobacco a lot more than not, that is for sure. Alrighty though, I'm going to go ahead and... it's going to be a little bit difficult for me to actually show you guys me rolling this because my rolling tray is down here and my camera's up here. But what I am going to do is I'm going to show you guys how much tobacco I am going to be using and everything like that kind of thing. I'm going to initially at least take out that much tobacco. I'm pretty sure that's too much, but I've got that much tobacco out for a cigarette. I'm just going to go ahead and kind of break it up just a little bit kind of thing, just to get that all in sort of like the shape of a tube. And now I'm gonna go ahead and put my filter in the rolling machine. I'm just gonna go ahead and start putting this stuff in. The shag cut tobacco loves to stick together kind of thing, which is both a good thing and a bad thing. It's a really good thing when you're trying to roll by hand. Not so great when you're trying to use a rolling machine, I will admit. I'm not gonna try to pack this super tight. I'm just gonna try to make sure it's tight enough packed. I'm thinking a little bit more. There we go. I haven't actually put the paper in yet. I'm just rolling it to make sure it's all good. I've got a little bit of tobacco left over. I'm going to go ahead and take the rest of the tobacco that's left over, and I'm just going to go ahead and shove it back in the bag, just like that. And now my entire rolling tray smells fantastic. Yeah, this stuff smells so good. This stuff smells so good. The grassy, sort of spicy. Oh, smells amazing. Smells amazing. I love it. Alrighty, then I'm going to go and open my rolling tray up, or my rolling tray up, my rolling machine up. Just see if it's all good and everything like that. I think that should be all good. Hopefully, I put enough in there. If I didn't, I can always try again. I might put a little bit more in there. Just having looked at it, I might put a little bit more in there. Not too much more, just a little bit more. Definitely the dryness of this. I'm using some of the drier tobacco right now. Definitely the dryness of it. It's definitely compacting down a bit more than not. So it's kind of hard to tell if I've actually got like enough in there kind of thing. I do feel like with a little bit more moist of rolling tobacco, especially shag cut rolling tobacco, it's a little bit easier to roll a cigarette with, just because it doesn't compress down as much and it kind of expands back out. It's a little bit easier, I feel like, but this stuff should work just fine as well. And I'm thinking with the extra added now, it should be all good. I'm gonna go ahead and put the little strands of tobacco I've got on here back in the bag. Can't be wasting nothing, you know what I'm saying? I say as I'm dropping stuff on the table, but that is what it is kind of thing. Nothing I can do about that. Go and just check in once again, and looks all good to me. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna tap it, just a little bit kind of thing. And I am gonna go ahead and get one of my Elements Ultra Thin rice papers all out. Just like that kind of thing. And now I'm gonna go ahead and start feeding it into my rolling machine. Which side is the side I'm supposed to use? It's this side. Oopsies, I messed that up. There we go. And I'm just gonna kind of roll it for a minute just to make sure it's all stuck together and everything like that kind of thing. I was having some issues rolling some cigarettes with some amber leaf a couple days ago, and my cigarettes, I was using my rolling machine with like the same filters and same papers and just with the amber leaf, and they kept coming out wrong. And I was like, what? I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm doing everything right. I was like, what's going on? Hope it doesn't come off out wrong on video. That would certainly suck. And thankfully it did not. Thankfully it came out just about perfect. That looks pretty scrumptious to me. And this is why I use a rolling machine in my roll your own tobacco videos, because it always provides the perfect cigarette. I'm going to go ahead and just take this tobacco off the end, just like that kind of thing. And I'm just going to go ahead and shove that back in the little bit of the pouch I have right here. And I'm just going to go and scrape everything back in. And I'm going to go and just fold this back up just a little bit kind of thing and put that tape back down, which, yeah, it doesn't want to be taped back down. That's okay. You know what I'm saying? That's okay. No biggie. You know what I'm saying? No biggie. I'm just going to go put that down on the table and just sit it on itself so it's all good. And now that I have this cigarette right here, I do suppose I should probably go ahead and get to smoking now, shouldn't I? I do suppose I should probably go ahead and get to smoking it and see how good or how bad the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco actually is. In this cigarette, it definitely looks like a darker blend than not, but in person, out of the cigarette, it definitely looks a little bit more like a medium blend, but definitely looks a little bit darker in the cigarette than not, that is for sure, which is quite interesting. And yeah, still smells absolutely amazing in the cigarette. Getting a really nice sort of grassy, spicy smell. Oof, smells fantastic. Without further ado, I do suppose I should probably go ahead and take a sip of water. And then after that, I'm going to go ahead and smoke a cigarette rolled with the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco and let you guys know what the taste is like, what the roughness of it is like, what other aspects do I have? What other aspects do I have? What the taste is like, what the roughness is like, what the strength is like, what the body is like, everything like that kind of thing. Let you guys know everything that you might want to know. Let me just put it that way kind of thing. First off though, I should probably get my lighter out of my pocket. And now, without further ado, oh yeah, and I want to find out how quickly this stuff burns as well. Probably slower than not due to the elements rolling papers, but might burn a little bit quicker than not. Without further ado though, let's go ahead and get this cigarette right here that was rolled with some Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag all lit up, and let's go ahead and see how it actually is. Yes sir, yes sir, you know what I'm saying? And right off the bat, ooh, that spice is coming through really nicely. That spice is probably the main taste right off the bat. I'm gonna go and grab myself a little bit of a screenshot. Hopefully that will do for a screenshot. We will see. Right off the bat though, the taste from this stuff is fantastic, but it's gonna take me a moment to really actually determine what the taste itself is. The main overwhelming taste at the moment is very much that sort of spicy taste mixed in with a grassy, sort of sweet, almost a hay-like taste kind of thing. Very much the Virginia and the dark-fired Kentucky coming in together kind of thing. Very nice, but to actually notice the undertones, it's gonna take a little bit more, it's gonna take a little bit of time for the tobacco to build up on my taste buds, on my tongue. And so as such, I'm gonna wait a minute to really give my definitive thoughts on what the taste of this cigarette is like. And so as such, I am gonna go ahead and talk about the other aspects of this tobacco real quick, such as roughness and smoothness. Seven out of 10, roughness and smoothness. Not super rough by any means kind of thing, not super rough by any means. Definitely pretty solid if I do say so myself. I am essentially smoking this unfiltered, and the tobacco I used was a little bit drier than not, and it's still not super rough. There is definitely a pleasant roughness in the back of my throat, and the spice definitely hit a little bit in my throat as well kind of thing, but not super rough by any means kind of thing, not super rough by any means. Yeah. Actually, that last hit was even smoother. Wow. For a roll your own tobacco, this stuff's pretty smooth, I'd actually have to say. Even with the spice in there and everything like that kind of thing. I'd have to say very much a 6 to a 7 out of 10. Definitely rougher than not. Not like super smooth, but... yeah. I haven't tried too many other roll your own tobaccos, I will admit, so I don't really have a super good comparison for like roughness and smoothness. But when compared to like normal cigarettes, like this is on the same level as like a Marlboro Red kind of thing. It's not any rougher than a Marlboro Red, which is pretty amusing. Certainly less rough than like an American Spirit Unfiltered or something like that kind of thing. And this is essentially unfiltered after all. So definitely smoother than like an American Spirit Unfiltered and stuff like that kind of thing, but not quite as smooth as like a Peace Unfiltered from Japan. Burning wise, this stuff's burning pretty slowly, but not the slowest I've ever had. Amber Leaf had a little bit more moisture in the pack, and due to that, it definitely burns a little bit slower, I've noticed, which is something interesting. I didn't realize. I mean, like, I knew the moisture level had an effect on taste and smoking and everything like that kind of thing, but it definitely smokes significantly slower than this stuff right here. Just due to the moisture level. And due to the Amsterdam Shag being a little bit drier, it does smoke a little bit faster, I definitely have to say, but still not super fast by any means, at least with the Elements rolling paper, which is pretty nice if I do say so myself. And so I've covered roughness, smoothness. Let's go and test the body real quick. Body is pretty good. Pretty dense body. Didn't put any perforation on the filter, didn't shove any holes on the cardboard filter or anything like that kind of thing, so it makes sense. And rolling wise, I feel like I did a pretty good job kind of thing. Not the tightest roll by any means. Certainly no complaints on my behalf, that is for sure. Took a very little draw, but got a decent amount of smoke. Decent body, that is for sure. What was the other aspect I was going to talk about? I'm going to talk about taste in just a minute kind of thing. I've already talked about roughness and smoothness. I've talked about body now. The quality of it tastes fantastic. There's no sort of chemical taste, no sort of additive taste, nothing like that kind of thing. I normally talk about, with cigarettes, taste, body, airflow, draw, roughness, and smoothness. I don't really need to talk too much about the draw with this because it's a roll your own cigarette and that just depends on how you roll it. There was something else I mentioned at the beginning of this video that I cannot remember what I said I was going to talk about. I cannot remember. Well, I'm not remembering it anytime soon, so let's go and start talking about the taste, though. I'm going to go and try to really start analyzing the taste. Oh, strength. Strength. That's what it was. That's what it was, is strength. Of course, the moment I'm like, oh yeah, I'll go and talk about taste, I remember what it was. Strength. Strength-wise, this stuff is nothing to be scoffed at. For sure, it's definitely stronger than not, especially essentially unfiltered. But it's not the strongest by any means. I've previously tried two other roll your own tobaccos, Bugler Blue and Amber Leaf roll your own tobacco, from Ireland specifically. The Amber Leaf was definitely much stronger than this stuff right here. And this stuff is more just like a normal sort of heavy full flavored cigarette. Very much, I'd have to say, more like a the Amber Leaf was like stronger than like, let's say, an American Spirit Black for comparison, which is one of the strongest cigarettes you can buy at most convenience stores in the United States. This stuff, on the other hand, is very much just more like an American Spirit Black. It's not really any stronger by any means kind of thing. It's definitely not a light cigarette by any means, that is for sure. Definitely not a light cigarette tobacco. Definitely stronger than not. Medium strength, apparently, this stuff is. I'd love to see what the full strength stuff is, that is for sure. But definitely stronger than not. At around about, like, if I was going to say whether this is really light or really strong kind of thing, I'd have to say this is probably right about a 7 out of 10 kind of thing. It's not the strongest by any means kind of thing, but it's definitely not quite the lightest either. And it's definitely not a medium tobacco. It's definitely more of a full strength tobacco, but not quite there, I definitely have to say, which I guess makes sense. Maybe half swear doesn't really mean medium strength. It means more like half strength, so it's not quite full strength. It's like half of full strength, but not quite a medium. Maybe that's what it actually means. And it did go out, but you know, I'm very much getting a half full strength, I'd have to say, but not quite a medium strength from this cigarette right here. It did go out though. This stuff stays lit pretty well, but I was talking there for a while without taking a hit, so it did go out. This paper is not paper that is designed to continue burning and burning and burning, and it is very thin paper after all, so I'm not too surprised it went out. I don't think that's the fault of the tobacco itself. I think that's more the fault of the paper, but that is one other thing to mention. This stuff does go out pretty easily. Excuse me, does go out pretty easily. So certainly no complaints on my behalf. Let's go and get this lit up once again, though, and actually talk about the taste now. I haven't talked about the taste yet, and that's really the only thing left I need to talk about. So what is the taste of this stuff like? So the taste, in my opinion, is a... mildly sweet, mildly citrusy, grassy, almost hay-like taste, I'm assuming coming from the Virginia tobacco, with a little bit of nuttiness as an undertone, I assume coming from the burley, and a lot of spice. The spice is very much the overtone, yet at the same time you can tell it's not the main part of the blend. It's just very much the condimental tobacco that leads the taste of the cigarette. That is for sure. The spiciness is the main aspect. But you can definitely tell it's not the most used tobacco, if I had to guess. The Virginia is probably the most used, as the main distinct taste is that, but then it's helped along by the spiciness. Yeah. Really, really, really nice, unique taste. I've never quite tasted a tobacco this spicy before, I will admit. I haven't tried. I've tried like some Kentucky flue-cured tobacco, but not like dark-fired flue-cured Kentucky tobaccos. I haven't tried a tobacco quite like this one yet. I will admit, this is a very unique smoke for me. This is a very unique smoke for me. But the Virginia is still very familiar. The spiciness is the main unique feature of this for me. But the Virginia is very, very, very familiar. And you do definitely get a little bit of a different taste when you're retrohaling. Then when you're just exhaling normally kind of thing, there's more depth to the taste. There's more depth to the taste when you're retrohaling. And the spiciness just loves to sit on the tip of your tongue. The aftertaste from the cigarette right after taking a hit is very much that spicy taste with an undertone of grass kind of thing. But when you inhale, it's very much more that grassy taste, and when you exhale, it's very much that spicy taste kind of thing, I definitely have to say. Interesting. Interesting, to say the least. Very familiar, yet very different. I've tasted Virginia blend tobaccos, like let's say Amberleaf, for example. The Virginia and the Amberleaf taste very similar to this stuff, although a little bit sweeter and a little bit more fruity, I'd have to say. This tobacco, on the other hand, the leading component is definitely that... spicy sort of burly, but it's not the component that's used the most. But yeah, interesting. Okay, and there's a little bit of a fruity taste in there as well. A little bit of a citrusy sort of almost sweet fruity taste. Yeah, okay, now that I've been analyzing taste a little bit, I think I'm ready to definitively say what the taste of the Amsterdam Shag, the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco is actually like. So the taste is very much a... The taste is very much a mildly sweet, mildly citrusy, slightly fruity, grassy-like Virginia tobacco taste, with the undertone being a slightly nutty taste, which is really nice, with the main leading component, which is still an undertone, but the main leading component of the tobacco is very much that sort of spicy taste. It's spicy. I'm trying to think of how to compare the spice to a food or something like that kind of thing for comparison. And nothing is really coming to mind. It's not salty. It's just spicy. So I'd have to say... maybe like slightly Cajun seasoning or something like that kind of thing, like slightly Cajun. I don't know. Yeah. That's very much what the taste is like. Very much a mildly sweet, mildly citrusy, grassy, fruity Virginia taste with a little bit of nut in there as well, kind of thing. Not quite like pecan, more like, no, kind of like a pecan, kind of like an unsweetened pecan or something like that kind of thing. No, not quite that either. Like pecan and peanut butter mixed together. Yeah, it's like pecan butter. Yeah, that's what it's like. It's like cashew butter. That's what it's like. It's like a cashew butter sort of nutty taste kind of thing. With the spiciness being the main lead component. Really nice. Yeah, not bad at all. Yeah, pretty good stuff to say the least. This stuff though, chain and head after hit is definitely strong. It's definitely strong, that is for sure. Half strength, I don't know what the full strength would be like. This stuff is strong, to say the least. It is some good stuff. It is some very enjoyable stuff. Let me just put it that way kind of thing. Certainly, no complaints on my behalf, that is for sure. I think I'm probably going to take another couple hits, and then I'm probably just going to stop it out right there kind of thing, because I am just about done talking about all I want to talk about. It's not getting particularly tarry towards the end of the smoke either, which I really do appreciate. And overall, the taste is fantastic. It's a really nice, unique, yet familiar taste to what I've had before. And just a really nice taste as a whole, I definitely have to say. Yeah, not bad at all. Very enjoyable stuff. A little bit strong, feeling quite buzzed right now, if I do say so myself. Smoother than not for sure. Definitely tastes a little bit dry. You can definitely tell the dryness of this tobacco. Comes through with the taste as well. That's one other thing I wanted to mention. Burns pretty slowly as well. I can't complain, you know what I'm saying? I can't complain. Well, I definitely do think I'm going to be enjoying smoking the rest of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco, that is for sure. I think I'm going to take one more hit, and after that I'm probably just going to step out this cigarette. I'll be frank, I got to piss. So I'm going to go and quickly wrap up my final thoughts, and then I'm going to go take a piss. I'm going to go ahead and stub this out on the ground, though. There wasn't too much left, so I don't feel too bad about wasting a little bit of tobacco. It is what it is kind of thing. But what are my final thoughts on the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco? What are my final thoughts on this Roll Your Own Tobacco right here? Well, the packaging, pretty good as a whole. Definitely a mildly classy, almost luxury-esque look. I like the packaging. I really like the black background. I really like the details on it kind of thing. It's not my favorite packaging by any means kind of thing. It's by no means a work of art. But it is nice packaging nonetheless, and I am a bigger fan of the packaging than not, that is for sure. The inside of the packaging looks pretty good as well, kind of thing, very informational. Tells you all about their other blends of Roll Your Own Tobacco and everything like that kind of thing, which I do appreciate. The quality of the tobacco is pretty good. The smell of the tobacco is fantastic. And the moisture level of the tobacco is a little bit drier than not. I feel like if you wanted to, you could add a little bit of moisture to it, and it might be a little bit less dry, and you might be able to get more depth to taste if you do make it a little bit more moist than not. And that's one thing I heard about the pipe tobacco variety of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam, is that it comes a little bit more moist, and so people say you can get a little bit more depth from it. If you moisten up the Amsterdam Shag a little bit, I feel like you might be able to get a little bit more depth to taste or something like that kind of thing. Taste-wise, and look-wise, the Amsterdam Shag is very much a medium blend, I definitely have to say. But quality overall, fantastic kind of thing. Smoking-wise, the taste is very much a sort of mildly sweet, mildly citrusy, grassy, sort of fruity taste with an undertone of sort of like cashew butter or like pecan butter or something like that kind of thing. But the leading component, the more so than not, overall component is that spicy taste. Really nice taste, if I do say so myself. Smoothness-wise, the smoothness was pretty good. Not bad at all, if I do say so myself kind of thing. Definitely like 7 out of 10, not super rough, even with that spiciness in there kind of thing. The aftertaste is very much a spicy aftertaste kind of thing with that sort of like grassiness in there kind of thing. Not really much sweetness, just very much that sort of spicy taste is very much the aftertaste, I definitely have to say, which I'm still able to taste right now. The roughness and smoothness, as I said, very much like a 7 out of 10. Strength-wise, is very much like an 8 out of 10. Not quite the strongest I've ever had, but still quite strong. Definitely a little bit stronger than a American Spirit Black or something like that kind of thing, but not terribly so. And Ease of rolling, very easy. Quality-wise, very good. Overall, good stuff. Overall, good stuff. Let me just put it that way kind of thing. I really like this stuff. This stuff is good. And I am definitely going to be enjoying smoking the rest of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag. That is for sure. Definitely is, out of the very small amount of roll your own tobaccos I've tried so far, a very good roll your own tobacco. Definitely very good. Very enjoyable. That is for sure. I certainly have no complaints on my behalf. I ain't gonna lie, y'all. Well, am I going to enjoy smoking the rest of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag Roll Your Own Tobacco? I am certainly going to enjoy smoking the rest of it, to say the least kind of thing. I'm certainly going to enjoy smoking the rest of it, that is for sure. Would I buy it again? Yeah, I do think I would. There are other, out of the other tobaccos I've tried previously kind of thing, there are others that are more to my preference taste-wise, I will admit. The Amsterdam Shag provides a really unique taste that I feel like I might crave at some point. And so as such, I can definitely see myself buying it again, that is for sure. And yeah, I really like it. I really like it. It's some good stuff. Really? I could see myself buying it again, that is for sure. Cost me like $9.50 for the pack, for the packet. So not super expensive by any means, especially for the amount of tobacco you get. Definitely get more tobacco in the packet than you do from a pack of cigarettes, that is for sure. And an American Spirit is about the same price in my area these days. So it's definitely a better deal than American Spirits, that is for sure. No sort of additive taste, no sort of chemical taste, no sort of low quality taste or anything like that kind of thing. Fantastic taste as a whole. It's some good stuff. I'd buy it again, to say the least kind of thing. But I'd have to say it's probably not my favorite rolling tobacco. I'd have to say that probably still goes to Amber Leaf. But it's still really good stuff nonetheless. That has a very nice, unique taste to it. And I could definitely see myself craving it in the future, that is for sure. It is some good stuff. That is for sure. But the main thing that kind of throws me off is the spiciness. I don't mind the spiciness by any means kind of thing, but just kind of makes me think I might get sick of it quickly. But there's only one way to find out, and that's to continue smoking the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, I do suppose, you know what I'm saying? But you know, good stuff to say the least. What is the rating I am thinking for the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag though? I'm thinking a solid, I'd have to say, oh yeah, burns pretty slowly as well. I'm thinking a solid 8.5 out of 10 though. I'm tempted to give it a 9 out of 10. Nah, I'm thinking, for this is only in comparison to other roll your own tobaccos I've tried. This is only in comparison. And I've only ever given reviews. Let me put it that way. I've only ever given reviews to three other roll your own tobaccos: Bugler Blue, Amber Leaf, and now the Amsterdam Shag. The Amber Leaf is very much to me like a 9 out of 10 kind of thing, just too strong for my personal preference. But the Amsterdam Shag is like right below it kind of thing, like an 8.5 out of 10, with the Bugler Blue being like a 4 out of 10 kind of thing, is what I'd say. Yeah, I really like it. I really like the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag, and I do definitely think that I'm going to enjoy smoking the rest of this pack right here quite a bit, that is for sure. I think that's all I had to say. I certainly hope you guys have enjoyed watching this quite lengthy review of the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag. If you guys have enjoyed watching this review, this video, of course, please make sure to like and subscribe for more content. Of course, let me know in the comments down below if you guys think I missed talking about anything. And of course, let me know in the comments down below if you guys have tried the Peter Stokkebye Amsterdam Shag before, and let me know y'all's thoughts on it. Of course, also make sure to check out my Instagram, my book, my merch, my P.O. Box, and my second channel, all in the description down below. Go check it all out. You know, thank you so much for watching, y'all. Till the next one, stay safe and peace and have a great one. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You know what I'm saying?